stop.
Enjoy the sky. We'll see what the universe tells us today. Studying if I should even take my gravel, but I'll take this opportunity to tell people to never feel shame to take your gravel. Okay, so I took my gravel, which is a step in the right direction, even though my face looks like this, which is, you know, I'm just gonna keep my expectations low because it's not looking good. Oh god, no. Morning. Monster. We on the monster.
So just to explain why that 50 feet mark sucks, it means that you have to break the murk at 50 feet, essentially dive in 50 feet before you could even see anything.
Alright. So it's a hard day for the freedivers. Murk until 50. So the tanker's walking.
You want to tell me that?
Yeah, the captain should have cut that.
Okay, hold on a second.
cuando me ay, donde no llegas, sabes que yo te llevaré. Dime qué quieres beber, es que tú eres mi bebé. Y de nosotros, ¿quién va a hablar si no nos dejamos ver?
So, no, let me see. Oh, yeah, them so just now.
Look at that jaw.
You have any fun facts about the hogfish?
This is not a... The name of this is a hog snapper. However, it is not a snapper. It's a family of the genus Ras.
Oh, excuse me.
Y'all, I was legitimately impressed by this impromptu lecture.
It's crabs and shellfish. Look at the jaw. Very pretty fish. And this, I believe, is a male.
He was right about that too.
The male is always prettier than the female.
Okay, I'll let you all decide that one in the comments.
Exactly where it's going.
So around here things were actually getting a bit hard for the tankers, so while they were taking their break, I decided, why not, let's try again. So I'm doing my breed up, then I'll do my peak inhalation, spit my snorkel, make my dive, and then I'll put my hand on my nose to equalize, because I know I'm gonna go a bit further than usual. One thing I want y'all to pay attention to here is, you see any change in colors? That's the difference in the layers of murk. You go from that green to that blue. Now it's still kind of white, but I'm trying to show y'all where I break the layer. Can't really see it, but you'll see it as I'm coming up. Obviously I'm disappointed, but I'm coming up. You'll see the difference in those layers there. And then I look at the camera and I'm like, meh. So while the tankers were tanking, I must take another one drop just to check out the conditions. As you can see, I have no gun because I'm really just trying to see if I could salvage the day for the freedivers, which would be Imran and I. You'd see I'm breaking the murk here. I'm trying to go a bit further to see if it's any better. I look around and you guys can't really tell, but it was a little bit better, and I felt like if I broke the murk earlier. So I started to think, okay, two things. One, I might have a good afternoon, and two, the tankers probably get through.
I tell her, I feel it, I get true, you know.
If Tangle was a fish, how about could you see? What do you want by gun?
If Tangle was a fish.
You want him?
Well, only two. A true one.
Out of the Tangle!
A spinning moonshine. You want to Tangle back on the other side?
Motion.
Moonshine just sort of spin.
It's kind of like on the gun, huh?
It's like 500 PSI on camera.
Wait, mention of that on camera.
Yeah, big, nice box.
Ay, ay, ay!
Wait, blackies!
God damn!
How long you bad boy.
Bad, 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 bad.
That's what we're talking about.
Watch this one, that thing in the mouth, all kind of thing, watch.
Beautiful bag.
Now, Olya, know your girl don't give up, right? I feel like Olya know that by now. I think I have my gun in my hand. I should have my gun in my hand at this point because I remember we moved to another spot and I was ready for them. Because the tanker said I was right. There's my gun. The Merc did move up, so you had less to dive through before hitting the reef, which is what we were looking for, and I was really excited, but of course I have to calm my heart rate down. And then I broke the Merc and ba-bam, before I could even check myself, I realized, okay, Imran shot a fish. Should I stay down? Should I get some footage of him? And I made the right decision as a dive buddy. I decided to swim to him. It was a really decent yellow jack, I believe. I'm swimming to him there now. You could see the difference in layers of the Merc that we had to burst through. And there he is fighting his first fish. Aye, 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 aye. Really nice yellow jack. And that was a great sign for the afternoon. Imran was being a super good freedive buddy because we were dropping in the same spot, but I was actually facing the opposite direction. So he let me know that the fish were coming from the back of the reef. So after a while, I was able to secure a nice yellow jack with ye good old bouncy shot. And I'll take this opportunity to let the young divers know that it's not always the shot that ensures that your fish is in the cooler, it's how you fight your fish. So for a shot like that, well, you see I got another one there and I put a better shot in it. But for a shot like the ye good old Bamsy shot, you have to fight your fish very carefully. Imran broke the Merc right into the school of yellow jack. As you can see there, I was about to shoot. Oh, a pug! He completely just let me shoot the pug and didn't shoot the yellow jack. Even though there was a whole school there, I definitely didn't see those yellow jack because I was so focused on the pug. I stole the pug. I came up. I didn't know how big he was. He looked super small there. We're still breaking the Merc. I'm now seeing this footage at the same time that you guys are seeing it. I'm so excited. This was one of the last drops for the day and I really needed a win.
Is it on?
It's going off.
Is it on?
I don't know, yeah.
I got it.
Ow!
Yeah.
Right man at the wrong time. I saw him this one and he turned and he started Sorry.
Kevin, this little girl falling for me, boy.
Real follow. Is he squeezy?
I lost that black rupa. I'm not coming back to look for the hogfish. No hogfish.
No
hogfish. I let it in my head bag anyway, my good.
So we're on the last drop of the day now. Imran has the GoPro mounted on his mask. He makes his descent, and by this point he knows exactly where he wants to make his dive. He's breaking through the murk and he's setting up to be ready. Looking around, as you can see, the water's a bit whiter now, but I'm just gonna let y'all experience this for yourselves. Okay, but wait, rewind. Y'all might be thinking this is the easiest shot of the day because they're quadrillion fish, right? But wrong. All green divers have gone through this at some point where you think that, okay, you have the fish in the bag, but it's near impossible to pick one because every time you see one you want to shoot, there's another one that's bigger, there's another one that's closer. You're excited, it seems super easy, you're mentally already seasoning the fish, and you're gonna miss. Ah, you thought he was gonna miss, but no, he is an experienced diver and we've all been through it, and that's why we can shoot fish now. So I was really impressed when I saw this footage because best believe I would probably run out of breath still trying to pick one, but he decided to just plug a fish, put in the shot, land it, because at the end of the day, a 4 pounds in the cooler is much better than a coulda, shoulda, woulda on a 10 pounds at story time. There's always a lesson to be learned. The videos really help for us to see what we may have done wrong or what we can do better in the future. And best of all, at least for me, I get to dive while I'm not diving.